Today I'm going to show you how I made this bass trap for acoustic dampening in this corner. It's completely full of mineral wool to absorb the sound. The structure uses ribs, so it's very rigid but also really lightweight. When the sound hits the ribs, it diffuses it a little bit, and you can make the ribs wider if you want more diffusion and less absorption. Stay tuned until the end of the video where I show you how the room sounds different with and without the bass trap by analyzing the sound waves. Let's go to the shop. I used a nail and a string to draw an arc on some plywood. And cut that arc on the bandsaw. Then I traced it and cut two more pieces. I used a large protractor to make marks every 15 degrees. I traced the end of my ruler to mark notches along the edge. I put masking tape on each piece and super glued the tape together to sandwich the three pieces. This works like double-sided tape, but it's easier to remove. I clamped the pieces onto a crosscut sled and used a dado stack to cut notches into them. I used a combination square to line up each cut. Now I needed some ribs for the structure. For those, I used a pine 1x6. I cut the end off and then cut it to length on the miter saw. Then jointed one edge with a hand plane. I ripped 7 strips to fit into the dados. Then I ripped a 2x4 into a 5/4-inch square for the spine of the frame. I cut a dado in the middle of that piece to house the middle shelf. Then cut a square out of the middle piece to fit it. I used a file to chamfer that piece so it would slide into the dado better. It fit very tightly, so I didn't add any glue, but if the fit is looser, glue would be a good idea. I attached each end piece to the spine with one screw. Once the spine was in place, I started installing the ribs. I used polyurethane glue so it would stick to the painted parts and also fill any potential gaps. I also pin nailed each joint to hold it in place while the glue dries, and add some strength. An 18 gauge finish nailer would also work well for this. Once the glue had dried, I used a file to clean up any excess. This is important because the polyurethane glue expands and can leave a mess. Then I sanded it a little and touched it up with some spray paint. I wrapped the frame with some thin, breathable fabric. First, I stapled 2 of the corners then the center. Then I flipped it around and started on the center, and then did the corners. I also stapled a midpoint between the staples. Then I switched to the end and put staples near the ribs. The weave of the fabric is two-dimensional, so I placed all the staples diagonally, which secures against forces along both axes. And went back to the sides and stapled all along the edge. And did the same thing on the ends. I used a piece of ribbon to hide the seam and the staples. I sprayed adhesive on one side and folded pleats on the rib sections. Then used a glue gun to secure any loose edges. I made a template out of cardboard and used that to cut some 3-inch mineral wool into a shape that fits the bass trap. Big thanks to my friend Travis, who's a professional insulator. He gave me these knives and advised me to wear gloves and long sleeves. I put all 16 of the pieces of insulation into the bass trap. Then I sealed up the back with fabric. I attached 3 picture hangers on the top of the bass trap for hanging it. The whole thing weighs 14 pounds, so it's not that heavy. Now I'm going to test the acoustics in this room with nothing in that corner. I'll do the same tests with the same microphone with a bass trap installed in the corner. It was very noticeable that there was an echo when I was clapping and when I was using the hammer. It definitely sounds a lot less echoey to me, but let's look at the waveform and see what it shows.
With the bass trap installed, the room noise has this nice wave shape to it. Without the bass trap installed, it's really ragged looking and it looks like there's a lot of noise. That indicates to me that the bass trap is capturing a lot of the smaller noises that are echoing around the room, not just the loud, more noticeable ones.
I'm really happy with how the bass trap works, and in combination with other acoustic treatments, makes the room sound really good. If you'd like to make it yourself, make sure to get the plans from my website, linked to in the description. Thanks for watching. Bye.